It's time for another Train Simulator 2017 stream. I am going to be doing this stream entirely out of boredom because I literally have nothing else to do. There's a new thingy. Ooh. All right, so anyways. I see they've made some improvements to YouTube. What? They made improvements to YouTube? Now that's unheard of. So, today we're going to be doing a scenario that I created on the Lawland to Boston route. I created this scenario a long time ago. It's still a work in progress, but I've decided that it's time to test out this scenario live on stream. And every time that I have been testing this scenario out, I've always seemed to quit around, say, the Westerly. But this time I'm gonna complete the whole scenario, which is gonna go from Wickford Junction to Lawland. Lawland indeed. I'm not expecting anyone to show up in the chat, but I'm just gonna do this stream anyways. But mind you, I am looking at the chat while doing this. Because, I don't want my stream to look like it's dead. It's an unscheduled stream that I'm doing entirely for fun. Is anybody watching? Okay, so there's two people watching. Not a single one. Not a single person has said anything except me. Oh well. Obviously I didn't plan this stream, but I'm doing it out of boredom. So a lot of you guys are probably going to see this stream in your subscription box and you're going to be like, oh no, I missed the stream, but don't worry. You can just watch this stream as a video, a YouTube video if you so desired. So yeah, later on. Yep. Yeah, later on I will be changing the name to this of the stream, and I will be giving it a custom thumbnail. Yeah, most likely a custom thumbnail, so I'll need to remember to take a picture along this journey, and then use that as a thumbnail. Right now I'm just talking to myself and whichever two guys are watching this stream. Here we go. Alright. Hello there! Today you will be taking the morning local service, making the following station stops at Kingston, Highville, Munich, Westerly, Newcastle, Creepy Town, Metro Park, Hines, Mead, Durham, North, Lawland, and Lawland. It's snowing in the summer, so this is Lawland at its finest. Hit it. So there's an MBTA train over there. That's a custom reskin that I downloaded, and I figured I would incorporate it into my scenario. Yeah, so right now I'm driving on the La La Land to Boston line, which you can't download at the moment. This is the route that I sort of made myself, but based off of someone else's route. Hey, look. There is the MBTA train. Now it's time for us to go. Alrighty, so we have a very low frame rate going. So you hear all those custom sounds? Yeah, these are custom sounds that I've modified for this train. You can download those. In fact, if you look through my train simulator and my train simulator playlist, you'll find that this is an existing mod that you can download for free. This is some kind of custom concept that I came up with, but this is the La La Land local service that goes from Woodford Junction to La La. I can get a better frame rate. Down the volume on my computer for a moment. And I gotta make sure that you guys can hear me. So I'm gonna test. Alright, so anyways, we have a viewer in the chat now. This is Isabel's Vlog. I love it. Friends that they should be able to see live. I definitely will consider it when I get my hair back, but for now. There we go, now we have a steady frame rate going. This bridge. So you probably are wondering, what is the story behind the La La Land walking? Well, so it started out as a group that came from the West walking that someone else built, and then the abandoned, not the abandoned, but basically the kind of project anymore. While we eventually continued on to build this loop, I think that was a steal this loop for myself. To build my own system. Unfortunately, the thing hasn't really worked out as well as I anticipated, but moving at a steady frame rate. So there's nothing to do. This is the large stuff. Dying. I'll probably just go up to Kingston right now then. Hello, Ryan has just joined us in the chat. He asked, what video editor should I use for reaction video? It's a long story. I might do a reaction video tutorial in the future, since the game might have had effect, but for right now, I'd say the best way to do it is to use iMovie, and then do a bunch of other things that I can't really talk about at the moment because I have not made a because I don't really know how to explain how I do reaction videos. But when I get my iPad Air back, I'll most certainly do a reaction videos tutorial. So yeah. Hello, 42-meter Wendy. Alright, let's go. Next up, Highville. I have a MacBook. Alrighty, so now it's on to Highville. And if I show you the collision ball, and it is 45 miles an hour. Yay. Hey, look, there's the Eastern Express train. Nice. The train is too loud. Well, as long as you can hear me, it's fine. Something for a moment. I'm gonna try to turn down the volume of the game. Okay, that should be better. Alright, so I'm sure you guys can hear me now. Let me know. Yes, perfect. Alrighty, I just had to turn down the game volume so I could fix the issue. By the way, disturb the train sounds. So yeah, Rita Okonye has joined the chat. I still don't know how to pronounce your last name. Yeah. Alright, so here comes the train. At least we have some people in the chat now. So how's everybody doing today? I'm absolutely fine. Fine and dandy. I was bored, so I figured I would do this. Why not? Later on today, I will be watching the NASCAR race in Texas, the O'Reilly Auto Parts 500 in Texas. I will be watching that. The pre-race show is going to be on at 11:30, but the pre-race show can be annoying after a while. I'm just going to watch the race when it begins until it's over. Also, one thing that I'm not happy about the Texas race that's happening today is that Kevin Harvick has the ball. And I don't like the fact that Kevin Harvick is driving a Ford at Stewart Racing. That annoys me. Yeah. Not only is it, I'm sure that my predictions are going to backfire and Kevin Harvick or Chris Busch are going to win the race. And, that's the thing. But I hope that doesn't happen. Okay, so we're maintaining a pretty steady frame rate. Apparently we are running at less than 15 frames 15 frames per second, but it'll be fine. I'm sure there's some kind of mini program out there that lets you see the frame rate. I may use that in the future, but probably not now. What else to talk about? Nothing else really. I'm really excited for this Texas race because obviously this is on the brand new replay. The Xfinity race yesterday was kind of boring. Like the Xfinity race from yesterday didn't really show what's gonna happen in the Cup race today. So I guess this weekend the Cup race is going to say it all about this new Texas replay, because the Xfinity race was pretty boring. Yep, as usual, the Xfinity race was dominated by Cup guys, that being Eric Jones, Kevin Harvick, Joey Logano, and Ryan Blaney. I'm sure most people are okay with Eric Jones winning in the Xfinity series, but now he has a Cup ride, so he really doesn't need to do anything else in the Xfinity series. I mean, Eric Jones hasn't won an Xfinity series championship, but he's running for a Cup championship now, so. And now the chat is dead again. The chat is always dead. Not always, but this is obviously an unscheduled stream, so I'm expecting no one to come here, but nothing else to talk about, really. I'll be having lunch at around 11:30, so I might need to pause the stream. Clean up to give you guys something interesting to watch. I don't know what's gonna happen. Okay, so I'm gonna begin breaking it for Highville a mile before it. Maybe less than that. I think it's just the train stops in time. If I overrun the platform, I'll automatically fail the scenario, which is no good. I mean, this scenario is at least an hour long, so. I need to get better at breaking points, because usually I either slow down too early or too late. Oh, wheel slip. That's no good. Okay. Why are you wheel slipping? Alright, well, I really need to slow down for the station because I have not been able to stop in time. Stop. See what I mean? Either I slow down too early or too late. I need to make sure that I don't stop completely until the very end of the platform, so I can fit this whole train in. Yeah, it's basically about 5 cars and an engine. Nothing too crazy. Alrighty, stopping at Highville. And thankfully, we have no timetable to worry about, so if we get us to a station at a slow speed, then it's fine. I may think about editing the scenario so there's a timetable in it. But it's probably gonna be an easy timetable. Alrighty, 10 stops left. Train gets jolted for some reason. I think it's because of the super elevation in the track. And the super elevation in the track is kind of jolty. Yeah, but easements do exist, but I didn't build this section of the line. Like beyond Westerly is where I built the route, but before that, it's all built by the guy who made the route. I can't remember his name. But we don't really like him. No one's taking anything in the chat. Is the cat dead? So coming up is Munich. Interesting. Get the cursor out of there. It's getting annoying now. Everyone's like looking at the cursor, like, ugh, that cursor is there. It's annoying. Ah. Plus, I only need the keyboard to drive. I need a thumbnail. I think right now is a good time. That's my thumbnail for the video. Good thing I remembered it. Okay, there's a go away. Alright, time to slow down to the station. Now we're going to Munich, which actually has some houses in it. Yeah. But overall, it's pretty much a dead town. In fact, lots of the towns in this route are dead. There's nothing to see. And I forgot to ring the bell. I am a bad train driver. Alright, only one more stop before Westerly, which is the part where we can enter some new territory. Because I still haven't yet been able to move on before Westerly. But I figured it's time to explore some new territory in this scenario that Ethan and I haven't discovered. I figured I would do it in a live stream form. Or a video form, I mean. I would record this as a video, but I feel like no one is gonna watch it. So I might as well just stream it on YouTube. So we'll get up to 40 miles per hour and then keep going up the throttle. Thirty minutes into the stream. Nice. At least there's something happening. I have 677 subscribers. Only a few of them want my stream. Hello! There's an ACS64 right here. Hello. Wait. Okay. I thought there was no sound coming from the wheels. Even weird. I presume that train just came from Westerly. Yep, 87% throttle at 87 miles per hour. That's a stream highlight now. That was actually a glitch in a previous version of this scenario that I had to fix. Uh-oh. Speeding. No, I was doing something with speeding. Oh no. Yes, well. Slow down. Slow down in the name of the law. I tried to do a thing. That thing didn't work out well. I hope that this train can stop in time. I think we're gonna make it. Oh look, there's a siding filled with a bunch of Amtrak and fleet cars doing absolutely nothing. Yep, this is nothingness. Now the game is lagging, which is no good, but I need to find out where I'm gonna stop at the station. Now we can lay off on the brake. There we go, much better now. And now we're going to slow all that brake around here. Okay, you can speed up now. Westerly Station. It's a dead town. Alrighty, stopping at Westerly. So this is the part in the scenario where I usually have to quit the game, because of some collision or because of some AI train not working, but this time I can actually continue on to the next stop. From here on, the speed limit will only be 50 miles per hour, but you will be allowed to go up to 90 miles per hour if you can. Alrighty. And this is like an issue, with the Lowland to Boston route, because when I was building the extension from Westerly to Lowland, I didn't change the speed limit to 130 miles per hour, which is what it was originally going to be, and I actually tried to set the speed limit to be 130 miles per hour, but the game just was playing up, so yeah. Honestly, this route is now nothing but trash, just a failed experiment, so... So I might add on to some extra scenery in this route, but track-wise, I'm not going to be adding any signals or messing around with the speed limit or anything like that. So, yeah. So next up is Newcastle, which is only 3 miles away. Yep. I'm gonna save my progress in this scenario just in case this scenario just decides to die on me. And it is officially 8 o'clock in the game, obviously. Obviously, I will need to redo this scenario from scratch. When I edit this scenario, I'll need to do it again from scratch and go all the way from Westerly to Whitford Junction to La La Land. But I'm just doing this scenario right now just so I can see that the destinations work and the AI trains do their thing. I mean, maybe I won't need to make any edits to the scenario at all, but I'm testing it out right now just so I can know that the AI trains are doing their thing. So I can make the edits to them if necessary. And I probably will. So yeah. So now we have two people watching the stream. Yeah, that's a pretty average watch level. Okay, so the stream started at 10:54 a.m. So, yeah. At least some people type stuff in the chat, because I once did a stream at this time of day a long time ago and no one showed up. I guess it's best if I stream for long enough to know if people are going to be watching the stream. We have two people watching right now. A one, or something, I don't know, maybe. And the cursor's in the way again. Alright, time to slow down. Oh dear, oh dear, uh-oh. I might have forgotten to slow down. Usually managed to slow down in the end, so I wouldn't be surprised if we did a good time by. Yep. Oh, right now we're wheel slipping? Are you kidding me? You're gonna make me wheel slip? Oh, come on, game. Why are we doing this? Ah. Well, here we come up to Newcastle. Free race view trial this weekend on NASCAR Cup Network. I will definitely use that. It means I have to charge up my iPad, because obviously now I'm using it up now. Can I charge up my iPad while doing this? Maybe. Nah, I won't do it. If the iPad begins to die on me during this stream, then I probably will. I need to remember to trigger the bell when coming into a station. So here is Newcastle. This is where Queen Victoria lives. Queen Victoria. So I want to give you a tour of Newcastle. Well, we have this big thing right here, which honestly looks more like a cardboard box. And there's the crane down there. There's a siding. It's random. And yeah. Alright, so Aaron Silva. I think they're in the scene. Apparently he or she thinks that this thing is boring. Well, this is the life of a train driver, so you can't really complain. So next up is Creepy Town. And Creepy Town is definitely a rather creepy town. Because there's like, whiskers? Whiskers, that makes sense. But there's flies and crickets and other things that are scary. Yeah, so Creepy Town, yep. So far are we away from Lawling, that final destination. 24 miles away, so we've already completed half of the journey. Alright, I'm happy. So we've already completed half of the journey and there's an AI train in the distance. Is it actually rolling or is it just sitting there? I might need to look at it. Let me check. Oh yeah, it's doing things. It's going very slow. It's doing things. Hang on, this is going to be an epic screenshot right here. Watch this. Oh, wait, wait a minute. Why is that car not flipped around? Oh, the cab car is facing the wrong way. I'll need to fix that. Now we're in a dead sector. Hooray. Oh well. Only diesel trains will be coming on the section of route because this section Like basically between Westerly and Lawland, it's not electrified, so of course only diesels can come along this section. I was also going to originally electrify this section of the track, but it could have been electrified by default, but I wasn't looking and I wasn't paying attention to the board thing, and so I laid down all this track without checking to make sure that it was electrified. Bad part on me. And again, like this part of the track that I'm driving on right now, you know, part that isn't electrified, I built this back in January of 2015. So this route is over 2 years old now, which is insane. Yep. Happy second anniversary of the Lawland to Boston. Who figured that this line would become so old? So we're over halfway through the journey now. I thought we still had like 40 miles or something. Something big or something crazy, but no. We're only, let's check again, 22 miles away now. Interesting. Speaking of 22, Joey Logano is going to be in the top 5 of the Texas race or rally thingy. NASCAR, that's happening today. Today indeed. Creepy Town. I actually tried to make a rail fanning scenario at Creepy Town, and it didn't work. Like, Train Simulator 2017 is a good game, but there are so much that can be done to improve it as well. It's like one side of this, like, okay. Pretend this game has two sides. It practically does. Like, one side is good, and the other side has a lot of room for improvement. And the improvements can so easily be done. But I guess Dovetail Games' focus on this game is just DLC after DLC after DLC. Because fun fact, Dovetail Games are the developers for this game, by the way. They release a new DLC for this game every single week. Whether it be a train or route or whatever. They release a new DLC for this game every single week. Yeah. And they also release a new version of this game like every single year. Like there's Train Simulator 2016, then there was Train Simulator 2017. And obviously Train Simulator 2018 is going to be coming out this year. But ever since Train Simulator 2014 or 2000, ever since Train Simulator 2015, they haven't really done any improvements on the structure of the game, like the menus or the things or the world builder or whatever. I mean, there have been some small improvements from time to time, but nothing overall crazy improvements. So here we are at Creepy Town, and there is a road here where cars go by, and there is a couple buildings here and there. So it's not completely dead, but usually when there are no trains here at Creepy Town, you hear crickets and stuff. That's very scary. Hey, look, there's a platform from the New York's New Haven route, which is a part of this route, obviously. Yeah. At least this time I remember to trigger the bell at the right time. Creepy Town indeed. Yeah, obviously that's not entirely realistic, but we can ignore the obvious thing that you can see right there. Door and the platform and all the obviousness. Yep, and it ain't obvious enough sometimes. Yep. For some people, things aren't obvious enough. Wow, Metroburg is only 2 miles away from here. can. I thought these stations were more further from each other, but I guess not. Alrighty, we have departed Creepy Town, and we are now entering, however, we take a look at this. There was a siding here at Creepy Town. I think it's a creepy place also. On this section of the line, instead of it being two tracks, it turns into three tracks. And eventually it's gonna turn into four tracks. Yeah, I just spoiled the fun for you guys. I did a couple videos on this route, a long time ago. Like, I remember I did a video of the Superclass 47, basically just flying down the line at supersonic speed. That was a crazy video. We have been live streaming for 52 minutes now. We have 4 likes on the stream. Nice. Yeah, what's annoying in the most recent update to YouTube is that now everything's frozen. Yeah. You can interpret that however you want. Hey, look, there's an Amtrak train. This is an F-40. This is epic. That Amtrak train is going rather slow. I might need to fix that. Yep. So changes will need to be made to this scenario, and here we are at Metro Park, the big city. I need to slow down and make the law. I need to slow down. Slow down in the name of the law. We're just going to make it. Alright, slow down to 30 miles per hour. Oh, we made it. I thought we were going to fly through the station and end up missing this platform, because then we would have failed the scenario. You can go faster than this. Look! Signs! Alright, so now let's explore Metro Park for a bit. So this is a massive city. A massive, massive city. A massive city indeed. Look, there's huge, massive buildings over there. 5 stops to go, yeah, we know that. And a bunch of other stuff. Yeah, it's basically a massive city. Look at this. Alright, let's continue. Oh. AI driver Amtrak number 1 has left path at longitude. I'm gonna make a note of that. Rest in peace scenario. Oh well, we might as well just finish in the quick drive. Oh, nuts. We were doing so well until that point. Wait, I think I have All right. Well, that concludes the scenario. Oh well, we might as well just finish it in quick drive. I'm not gonna drive the super class. I'm just gonna drive the other train that I had before. I know I have a custom concept of it. Actually, I need to make sure what are like the markers are like because, yeah, in Beirut, no kidding. So where's La La Land to Boston? I might have a quick drive starting point at Metro Park, so I can just finish the journey and then make some edits in that scenario. And then, be back. Okay, so I just have Woodford Junction, La La Land, Newcastle. So I just have it at starting in Newcastle. Okay. So I'm going to go from Newcastle to La La Land. And because I don't want to spend too long, I'm just going to do it in the Superclass 47. Yeah. How about I do it in the Jet Train? Yeah, Jet Train Yellow, Jet with Coaches. So I left it at 8:30. And it was summer with cloudy snow. All right. So we're going to finish the journey like this. Yeah. So apparently Amtrak train number one has left thingies. I'll need to fix that. Must have crashed into another AI train or something. I don't know. I'll find some way to solve the problem. Maybe I need to use portals or something. Oh well, we're gonna finish this journey no matter what. I don't want you guys to watch the video and be like, "Oh, but you didn't finish the journey to La La Land." I'm gonna finish it somehow. Alright, so we're obviously here at Newcastle with the jet train. I'm just gonna fly up. Yeah, I'm just gonna fly up to La La Land and I'll make any station stops and pretend that this is like the express train. We are pulling coaches, so don't worry. I just heard banging outside my house. That was insane. Like the train, so yeah. So we're just gonna build up our speed as much as we can. We're just gonna fly down the line. And you would think that I would crash in spectacular fashion, but I'm actually gonna try to slow down and stop at La La Land. We are wheel slipping, but we're accelerating, so it's fine. I think you can turn off the cursor in OBS, and I probably will do that eventually. Yep, finishing the scenario in an unexpected fashion. I'm gonna slow down a bit because I don't want to derail just yet. I mean, we've only just not started. We want to make it to La La Land and then do something insane. I don't want to jeep you guys with just having the scenario crash at Metro Park and then not finishing it all the way to La La Land. So eventually, I will be redoing this scenario. As it should be. But the one we're just going to do now is I am going to, as soon as we get to La La Land, that's when I'll close out the live stream. Coming up on Creepy Town. Yeah, there was a woman on the platform, but other than that, nothing else. So, she probably got swept away, but that's fine. Alright, coming up on Metro Park already. Now, this is where we left off. I would slow down, but nah. 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 So you guys can see what you would have seen if we this scenario would have continued on. In fact, I'm even going to go into this view just so you guys can see ahead of the track. Flying by Metro Park at 227 miles per hour. So this is where the scenario crashed, but this is where it continues on. Alright, so at this section of the line, it goes into four tracks. Now we're going along the express line, and this is the local track where we would have went if the scenario hadn't crashed on us. So I will need to fix that Amtrak one thingy crashing during the thing. Flying along the line at 244 miles per hour. Can we hit 250? I think we most likely will. Oh, the mileage isn't counting down. That was a jolt and a half. Can we hit 250 miles per hour? Gonna be close. Yes, 250. Alright. Coming up on Mead. Mead indeed. Hold that in that local train scenario and get anywhere. Oh well. At least I know that the scenario has faults. And that's important if you're a developer. Alrighty. Actually, should I just continue the stream on from here or should I just end it? Nah. I'll do something after this just to keep the stream going. Yeah. It was originally just going to be me grabbing from Whitford Junction to Lolland in a scenario form, but now that's not going to be a thing anymore. So after this quick drive scenario thing, I am going to use the bathroom, and I'll join you when I'm done, and we shall play another scenario on another route. I'm not sure what that route is going to be. I'm thinking about making a high-speed line. Oh, hello! Nah. I can put that there for fun. It's all for lol. Alright, here's Durham. And this is the final station before Lolland. So I'll need to slow down. And there's Durham! Yay! Durham. Durham Castle. Durham indeed. Durham, all the Durham. Alright, time to start slowing down. I'm gonna slow down as gradually as I can. Just so I don't derail the train. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is the final station. It is! I'm gonna slow down! Slow down! Slow down! We're coming up fast! Oh. I have faith in you, train. Slow down! It's not gonna be enough. We're not gonna slow down in time. There's no way we're gonna slow down in time. There is no way that we're gonna make the sharp corner. We're gonna crash. Oh, no. Stop in the name of the law! Train, it's not good. We're not gonna slow down time. Oh, I tried, but nope. I tried. Oh, man. Well, we need to do something, so one more quick drive from Lolland to Durham. In a more sane train. I didn't look at like an impressive diesel train. Let me see. What about the multi-level cab cars? We're gonna go in diesel mode. We're gonna take the cab. Yeah, we'll have the engine in the lead. All right, so I'm gonna quick take a quick bathroom break, and I'll be back with you in a second. Alrighty, I'm back. No one is here yet, but eh. Let's start. Alrighty, so no extra viewers have came in during my bathroom break. So yeah. So this stream has officially gone over for over an hour. Yeah, I was expecting just to do the scenario from start to finish and then end this in, and then the end the stream, but right now, my daddy is in the shower. So, yeah, and then we're gonna have lunch. So as soon as daddy begins to cook lunch, then I'm gonna end out the stream. Automatic power switch over disabled. All right. Well, we are at diesel to start. So here is the city of La La Land in its full form. That's the station. That's the Empire State Building in La La Land. The Empire State Building, indeed. There's a couple other buildings that I put in just for fun, and a massive rock thing with a platform sticking out of it. How many of you guys have seen this before? I'm sure none of you guys have till now. So yeah, this is the you might hear some strange sounds, and that is the building. All right, time to go. Actually, no, I decided that. Nah, I'm gonna end the stream after this. Holy crud, the passengers are beneath the platform. Okay. Okay, so what I've decided to do now is that I'm just gonna finish up at Durham and then I'm going to end out the stream because the NASCAR pre-race show is probably on right now. I'm gonna go watch that. And I'm also gonna watch a couple other videos on YouTube, so I've decided that. When we finish this journey, that's gonna be the end of the stream. Oh, I wish I could have finished that scenario, but stuff happened. So we are going on the local line, so we will be able to stop at Durham. We're just gonna go up to 30 miles per hour and then not go any further, not going faster. I also forgot to ring the bell before I left the station. Slow down. I need to ring the bell. Ah. That looks ugly. Oh, just the inside. I thought it was the outside. Yeah, hear those sounds? That's a mod that you can download. I think I called it the something 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 mod. I make a lot of mods, don't I? Who knows, maybe one day I'll work for Dovetail Games on their sounds. Alright, so there's the bend where we crashed. Now we can speed nicely up to Durham. This stream has gone on for an hour and 10 minutes now. I think it's an hour and 20 minutes, right? An hour and 15 minutes. Yep. This has been a long stream. Not really. Did it for a live stream. You would think that a normal live stream would be about, say, a couple hours long. And the stream that I did yesterday was a couple hours long. This stream would be an hour long. Okay, so there seems to be some sort of bell noise in the horn. Yeah, it's very faint, but you can hear the bell sound in the horn. Sound thing. Yeah, I may need to fix that. Yeah, I made this mod about last summer of 2016. Well, interesting story right there. Alright, now I need to slow down. Also, I don't know why the train is making electric sounds, because we are in diesel mode. I guess the game is confused or something. Maybe it is. Because the sounds programmed for this train aren't perfect. Yeah, the train is making electric sounds, which is not realistic. You don't see a train in diesel mode making electric sounds. I'm blaming it on Dovetail Games for messing up. Alrighty, we're coming up on Durham. Then that will conclude the live stream. Yep, conclude the live stream. And there's Durham. Durham Castle. Buried in the ground, isn't it? Back to another cardboard box thingy. Yep. It's 2017, and certain things in video games look like cardboard boxes, although this This particular asset, the castle, was made about, say, in the year 2005, when Dovetail Games was beginning, was just starting out. I need to slow down. So yeah. So yeah, I think they originally started out as Kuju Entertainment. I need to slow down. Slow down, train. Slow down. It's gonna overshoot the platform. Nope. Gonna stop just in time. Doesn't matter if the locomotive goes over, but it does matter that the coaches go over. Stop just in the nick of time. Alrighty, that's going to conclude the stream. Obviously, we gotta wait until the passengers get out. And doors are closed. And the scenario is over. So guys, that's going to wrap up all the Train Simulator 2017 action for today. Overall, I'd say this was a pretty good stream. I kind of wish I could have finished the scenario that I made, but I guess I need to make some fixes to it at the same time. But guys, that is going to be the end of this live stream or video, whether you're watching it as a stream or video or whatever you so desire. Yeah, OBS is being weird with the sound and stuff. Well, anyways, guys. That's it for this video. Or a stream or whatever. And I will see you next time.